Hey, lovely people. So if you're wondering what peripheral neuropathy is, I am going to tell you now. It is nerve pain that you can get from a variety of sources or reasons, but one of the big reasons that's relevant for me and other people with cancer is that you can get it from chemotherapy. So in that case, it's called chemotherapy-induced neuropathy, or specifically chemotherapy-induced peripheral neuropathy. Peripheral because it's in your extremities, like your hands and your feet, and neuropathy just basically means like disease of the nerves. However, how it manifests is that you get tingling or numbness or pain in the tips of your fingers all the way into your hands and your feet. And generally speaking, at least in my case and with the chemotherapy I'm getting, which is a platinum-based drug, you can get neuropathy as a side effect, specifically when it's cold-induced. So if it's winter and you have to go outside, you can even get pain in your throat from breathing in. And that happened to me as well. In fact, I wasn't even able to tolerate room temperature liquids to drink. So that's interesting. Basically just drank tea for like a week straight because my throat hurt whenever I drank anything that was even just room temperature, let alone anything colder. And it just started, it's like, it feels like shards of glass in the back of your throat kind of going down. And then when your fingers get all tingly and numb, you can't even do up a button, or, you know, you can't really type very easily. So I've been having difficulty typing at times, but there's a few hacks for this. So just old-fashioned running gloves and the little digital sort of touchy pads that they have, they can be really good to use indoors when you're having some issues. Even though inside your house you're generally a comfortable temperature, sometimes it can crop up because maybe your circulation isn't that good, and so your hands and feet get a little bit cold, and just popping on the gloves, and you can still read on your iPad or, you know, your phone and do very basic typing. I find the little pads, they're useful, but they're not as good as just your fingers. And or you can get fingerless gloves. So I'm actually currently making kind of DIY hand warmers. I might do a video once I have that finished, but you can find lots of other videos online of people who do, you know, DIY hand warmers from all kinds of different things. So I'm making mine out of an old pair of yoga pants that I no longer use. And so just, you know, cutting them up and sewing them together, and you just kind of have like fingertip free, but just a little bit more coverage on your hand, and that can really help. And when you're going out, basically the trick is you gotta bundle up and stay warm. There's really no other way. Wrap a scarf around your mouth, you know, so that you're, when you're breathing in, the air warms up as you breathe it in. And make sure that you don't forget your gloves and your hat, of course. So that's it. That's what chemo-induced peripheral neuropathy is. There are a number of different things that you can do to prevent it or to try and manage it when it does happen. I'm looking into some different sort of dietary things that I might be able to do that, you know, protect the nerves. When I come up with something, I'll be happy to share it. For now though, basically what I'm doing is staying warm, and it's so far working pretty well. The other day, it can sometimes crop up completely unexpectedly. The other day I didn't think it was going to be an issue at all, and I was taking a pan of soup out of the fridge, and the pan was metal, and holy, I basically dropped it. It didn't really work out too well, but yeah, with my first round of chemo, touching even a doorknob that was metal, even though it's indoors and it's warm and it's fine for anyone else, for me was very painful. So if you are on chemotherapy like me and you are experiencing peripheral neuropathy, then I recommend just getting some running gloves because they're thin enough that indoors you're not gonna overheat, but they'll keep you comfortable, or some hand warmers, and definitely keep your feet warm. So some fuzzy slippers are highly recommended. And for now, that's about it. So see you next time. Thanks for watching. And if you like my videos, please subscribe. That would be absolutely amazing, and I really appreciate it. And yeah, if you have any ideas for things you'd like to see more about, leave me a comment, and I will make some more videos soon. So I will see you very soon. Bye for now. Mm-hmm.